how should you split then your money? I mean, like you mentioned, right? We should try and keep the equation as income minus savings is equal to expenses. So that savings bit to ensure that, you know, it's able to keep up with inflation. How do you ensure, how do you split it up across all the investments you mentioned? Equity, of course, being a prime one of them.
Sure. So there is a completely logical mathematics to this, right? Let's take inflation at 6%. And let us aim that we must earn about 12, because practically speaking, inflation is not really 6. That's the government number. In our lives, it's much higher, about 8 to 10%. So we aim to earn 12% growth on our money. Now, if you had to get 12% growth, what would you do? You would have to, let's say, put 60 to 70% money into equity, where we assume that our earnings are 15%. And the remaining 30 to 40%, let's say, in debt, where the earnings are expected to be 6%. So if you, for example, multiply 70% into 15% and then 30% into 6%, you get a mathematical average of about 12% plus or minus. So that means in today's time, even if you're a senior citizen, and I want to say that again, even if you're a senior citizen, you're not going to consume all the money on one day. But not having equity in your portfolio is going to be extremely, extremely dangerous, because in the future years, you might be 60, 65 now, but when you reach 70 and 75, and let's assume the interest rates are down to 4% or, you know, maybe 4.5%, what would you do? That's the time these equities could be translated and converted into fixed deposits. So therefore, at any point of time, 60, 70% is like a bare minimum. And if you're younger, even if you are at 90% or 100%, it's perfectly okay, because you've got so many more years in front of you. And don't worry, 20, 30% volatility happens all the time. But the only sure shot way to beat a 6%, 8%, 10% inflation in our lives, and in a country like India, where social support system is not adequate, government benefits are not the way they are in the European countries and the Western worlds, where you have to do a lot for yourself. One thing, of course, buy your health insurance. The other thing, get all your money into equities. And whether it's mutual funds or whether it is direct equity, that's your choice, and that's based on your capability of management. But look at the 60, 70% number in equities. I think that's the number to go home with.